Hello, I'm Graham, and I do hope everyone's staying safe and well during the time where our governments are asking us to stay isolated and keep away from one another, keep our social distance, stay indoors as much as possible to limit the spread of this massive pandemic of COVID-19. Anyway, today it's a video about a power distribution plate that I found from a company that's marketing it called Gonine. Now, this power distribution plate is ideal if you're shooting video quite a lot. Say with Canon 90D camera, if you're using the internal batteries, they're very small, 7.2 watt hours or something like that. Don't give you very much runtime when you're shooting 4K UHD video. So the solutions are to use a dummy battery box that you place in the battery compartment, and then you can power that from lithium-ion external batteries, or you've probably seen on my photoblog, if you follow me along, I've devised this USB-C power delivery device, which then sets the output to be 8.4 volts, and then you can use that to power your camera. Or you can use these battery plates, which takes the larger Sony NP-F series batteries, and again, you can plug this into the dummy battery, but that doesn't mean you're carrying a lot of these larger, heavier Sony NP-F series batteries. If you are going to be shooting indoors, then you're probably going to be using a mains wall adapter to convert your wall mains voltage down to the 8 or 8.4 volts for your camera. Again, this one is a power device, 8 volts at 3 amps, marketed again by that same company Gonine, and that plugs into your dummy battery box, and then that can be used to power your camera. So that's fine if you want to be using just a single wall adapter for your camera. But supposing you've got a rig and you've got a monitor on there, you might have an additional light source that you want to power. How do you power those? Would you put 3 wall adapters onto the unit and have all those trailing cables? Well, no, the answer is this power distribution plate. Again, it's manufactured or marketed by Gonine, and it allows you to plug your single supply into this device. And it's got 2 paralleled outputs. So again, you would plug your 8 or 8.4 volt adapter into a convenient port. And this one, it's nicer to put it into the bottom one. These are 2 free ports. All these ports are paralleled up. So it doesn't matter where you plug them in or take your power output from. They do supply you with the Sony LP100 cable, which allows you to plug into one of those sockets if you've got one of the Sony compatible type connectors. Otherwise, you can use your standard 5.5 to 2.5 millimeter connector, and again, you can plug that into your dummy battery box like so, and that would again plug into your power distribution plate. So now we've got the mains adapter supplying my camera, and then you could also take another output lead and plug that into your monitor directly if you want to use the adapter cable, or you can plug the plate onto your device if it takes the LPE6 type batteries, which are almost an industry standard. So this device is that power distribution plate, but the beauty of it is inside the device is an electronic circuit which has a power MOSFET and 2 shunt regulators. Now the shunt regulators are in there to protect the external equipment. There's one that's set to provide undervoltage protection and one set to provide overvoltage protection. So if your wall supply drops below 6.4 volts, it will turn off the power to that connected peripheral. Or if it goes over 9.4 volts, again, it will turn off the power to that device. So it gives you added protection for the device that you've got this clipped into. So here on my rig, I've got the adapter plate plugged into my HD monitor. And the output from that is going into my FZ2500 on the camera. And the whole rig is here powered by a lithium ion battery. So it's providing power to the whole rig. Plenty of power. If you wanted to use the AC adapter, of course, then you just change the input from the lithium ion battery to the AC adapter. Now the whole device is rated at 7.2 to 9 volts at 5 amps. That's for the 3 inputs, which are in parallel, and for the power output to the plate, which is through that MOSFET and totally protected circuit. So hopefully you'll find that a useful product if you want to have more than one device connected to your single power source for your camera rig, etc. Well, that's it for the video. Please do stay safe, stay well, and hopefully I'll see you in my next video. Goodbye for now.